I'll show you how to create a website using Hostinger, complete with your own website name, an SSL certificate, a professional business email, and some must-use free optimizations to make your site as fast as possible. If you already have a Hostinger plan, skip to this part in the video to save yourself some time, but everyone else, let's start from the very beginning. I'll be buying the premium shared hosting plan for 12 months, and I'll be grabbing an extra 10% discount by using the code Emit.Reviews.
LAPD, get on the ground, this is the discount police!
You can get the same discount by using the link in the description. I'll just fill these details out, and I'll see you in the dashboard. Okay, now let's make ourselves the website. You can skip the first questionnaire. For our content management system, let's choose WordPress, which means you need to create your WordPress login real quick, and we can skip the theme since we'll be getting something much better later. Finally, claim your domain name. Just type in how you want to name your website. I'll go for emityt.com and see if it's available. Great, looks like nobody has taken it, so I can use it for this video. Now, this is a very important step. You need to choose the server where your website will be stored. Choose the server that's going to be closest to your user base, not you. Since I'm European and I expect visitors from Europe, I'll go for the Netherlands server. Now, I'll need to provide information to register my website name. And finally, let's go to our control dashboard. Okay, so here's how you navigate Hostinger. Click on Home and you'll see all of your services in one place. In this video, I'll go over several steps, so let's start with the basics, our website setup. Click on Manage next to your hosting plan and you should see this dashboard button if you installed WordPress during the previous steps. If you don't see a dashboard button, just scroll down, choose WordPress and follow the instructions. You'll be taken to the dashboard automatically. First, check your PHP version. At the time of making this video, version 8.1 is the newest version and the one you should be using. So let's update it by going into the PHP configuration and changing it to 8.1. If we would visit your website right now, you would see that it's pretty much empty and it still has this not secure message on it. Let's fix that. Go back to your Hostinger homepage and set up the free SSL certificate that Hostinger provided. Okay, this might take a couple of seconds, but the page will refresh itself once the certificate is activated. Now, if you would visit your page again, you would see that the connection is secured and there are no error messages. Okay, let's work on the design. First things first, click on WordPress and then Dashboard in your Hostinger panel. Then click on Edit Website. As you can see, the automatic installation comes with a lot of unnecessary plugins. So go into Plugins and deactivate, then delete everything that's not the Hostinger or Lightspeed Cache plugins. The less useless plugins we have, the faster our site will be. Next, click on Appearance, then Themes and Add New. If you don't see it already, search for the Astra theme and simply install it by clicking here. You should immediately see a Get Started button once you're finished activating. Click this button here and then choose a theme that you like the most. Look for themes that have no premium tag since those are paid. I'll get something from the personal page section, but feel free to choose anything you want. Finally, just continue through these steps and you will be able to edit your website later. So for now, just wait for the installation to finish. Done? Good. If we would visit our website right now, it should look like the template we just selected. Now, everything is extremely simple to edit here. All you need to do is click Edit with Elementor and type away. You can also drag and drop these sections to change positions or delete them altogether. I won't go into detailed customization for this tutorial as everyone has different needs, but I'll show you how to optimize your website for speed after you're done editing it. Navigate back to your WordPress dashboard, hover over Lightspeed Cache, and then choose General. Here, you'll need to click on Request Domain Key. The approval process will take some time. For me, it was only 5 seconds this time, but I had instances where it takes several minutes. Next, click on Link to Quick Cloud and sign up for an account. After you're done, just confirm your email address and you'll be taken back to the Lightspeed dashboard. Next, click on Cache and enable Mobile Cache. Click on Save Changes, of course. Moving along, enable Object Cache in the Object section and enable Browser Cache in the Browser section. As always, don't forget to click Save Changes after each one. Moving on to image optimizations, the first time you do this, it will take some time. You'll need to click on Gather Image Data and then Send Optimization Request. At first, the plugin will only optimize one image, simply to check if the connection is stable. The problem is, you'll need to wait 5 minutes before submitting a new request. So while you wait, let's go into Image Optimization Settings and select Image WebP Replacement. This will replace your website images with the WebP format instead of JPEG or PNG, reducing the amount of space your website takes up by like 40 to 50%. Following this, just continue with the image optimization process. It's annoying and slow at the start, you'll need to do it multiple times, but keep doing it until both of these circles have a checkmark. That means you've optimized all of the images on your website. Once you're done with the images, go into Page Optimizations. First of all, you'll need to check Lazy Load Images in the Media settings and activate Responsive Placeholder. Next, for these three settings, it's quite tricky because they can actually make your website look worse or break completely. The way I do it is I just activate a couple of settings at a time, I go back to my website and I purge all cache to see the newest version. I browse around to see if everything's looking fine. If it is, I activate the next batch of settings. If it's not, I deactivate the ones I just activated. So I recommend you do this as well. Astra themes are pretty good at not breaking while tweaking these settings, but be careful. It's definitely something that can mess up your site, and if that happens, just deactivate the setting and forget it ever existed. Okay, let's give our website a quick test. And pretty darn good if I say so myself. The website only takes 0.7 seconds to fully load, and it's full of images. Hostinger is doing some great work here as well, responding within less than 0.1 seconds. But we're not done yet. As you can see, we have the suggestion to use a CDN, and that's exactly what we're going to do. A CDN is a content delivery network. It saves your website files in servers all across the world. So when people try to reach your site, the information is sent from the closest server instead of the same location every single time. Less physical distance traveled means a faster site. The CDN I always use is Cloudflare. And while Hostinger has an option to connect your website to Cloudflare, it's paid. However, you can do it for free. Let me show you how. First, go to cloudflare.com and register for an account. Then select the free plan and click continue. Once you're in this screen, all you need to do is go back to your Hostinger panel, click on Domains, then click on your website name, and next to the name servers, click Change. Now, just copy and paste the two name servers from Cloudflare to Hostinger. Yeah, and that's pretty much it. Cloudflare will now distribute your website files across servers all across the world, making your website faster worldwide, completely free. Keep in mind that this change might take from 5 to 20 minutes to take effect. You'll know once it's done when you refresh your Cloudflare page and see this green checkmark. Okay, finally, let's get you a professional email address, completely free of charge. Simply navigate to Emails and choose the free option, create your desired email address together with the password, and log in. Yeah, it's that simple. You can have as many emails as you want, as long as it's not more than 800. So at this point, I have a great looking website that loads incredibly fast for what, like around $30? Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay, so the only thing that's left to do now is making your website secure. You can do that by following this tutorial right here. So outsmart the hackers and get ahead of the website game. I'll see you guys later.